all to stand up. Come on. You know, today is Pentecost Sunday. It's the birthday of the church. Ayan, pakibati nga po ng mga katabi. Happy birthday! Alright. You know, today is Pentecost Sunday, and I believe that Pentecost Sunday is a gift of a new day. Gift of a new day. Can you say new day? And today we celebrate the gift of a new day wherein we get to see more of God's goodness. A new day to rise up from our problems and a new day to experience joy in the Lord. Yes? And since it's the birthday of the church, I believe we have enough reason to be extra joyful today. Can you say joyful? And so can I count on you that we're gonna sing, we're gonna dance, we're gonna party in this place, and we're gonna rejoice in the Spirit of the Lord. Amen? Amen? Can I count on you? And so let's come into worship. Come on, put your hands together.
The tightness of my vision often hinders me to see your plans for me. I forget that in every season, you're the one who's gotten me through my thick and thin. But you're still so good to
me. Come on,
me.
Smiles on your faces, we sing.
My King, forever I will sing of the wonders of your love, your love that gives me peace. Your life, you gave it all for me. There is no fear that will keep your love away from me. I'm alive and now I'm free.
Come to seek God. seek God today. Amen. You know, in the book of Jeremiah, God said, in those times when you pray, I will listen. If you seek me wholeheartedly, you will find me. And today, as we come into prayer, as we continue to worship our good God, let's just remember these words in our hearts so that we can really seek Him with all of our hearts, so that we may remember that He is all, that He is in all our moments, that He is all in the good and all our trying times. Amen. For God is here. God is in your life. He is with you and He lives in your hearts. Amen. And so through the Holy Spirit and confidence, we can come to God today to seek Him. As we make the sign of our faith in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Just open your hands to God. This is something comfortable for you. Jesus, we believe that you are here, surrounding us with your love and mercy. Lord, we believe that even before we seek you, you seek us first. Even before we find you, you already live in our hearts. But just the same, God, we've come here to seek you with all of our hearts. You know our battles. You know what is in our hearts, God. And so we just surrender to your power. So allow us, God, to encounter you today. May we see you in all your goodness and faithfulness.
There's a grace where my heart is on the fire. I know the way when the walls are closing in. When I look at the space between where I used to be and this reckoning, I know I will never be alone. There's another in the fire standing next to me. There was another in the waters holding back the sea. Should I ever need reminding that I've been set free, there is a cross that bears the burden where another died for me. There is another in the fire.
Is it real?
There is no other name but the name that is Jesus. He who was and still is and will be through it all. So come on, may end the space between all the things unseen and this reckoning. I know I will never be alone.
Come on, declare it, I know.
I know I will never be alone. There'll be another in the fire standing next to me. There'll be another in the waters holding back the seas. Should I ever need reminders, can you appear to me?
Lord, you're Lord.
of Lords. He is our Savior, our healer. We praise you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Good afternoon, Feast. You know, a few months ago, I saw this photo on the internet, and it's a picture. Can we show them? It's a picture of a church that was hit by a tornado. And the story behind it is this. It's a church in Kentucky, USA. Hindi Kentucky Fried Chicken, ah. Okay. Nge, corny, di ba? Para lang magising kayo, alright? So it's in Kentucky, USA, and they were hit by a tornado. And this tornado had speeds of about 135 miles per hour. So it really wreaked havoc across that church, destroying the roof and the roof collapsing and everything just being torn down. Now, as that was happening, as the tornado was pummeling against that area where the church was, there were about 40 preschool children and 10 staff members, teachers, inside the church. Now, praise be to God, because miraculously, they come out of all of that, that tornado, unscathed and unharmed by the tornado. But what I find interesting, what I find more inspiring in this story is that, yes, praise God, they got out of it safe, they're all good. But in the midst of the tornado, according to the reports, according to the story, in the midst of the tornado, do you know what they were doing? While everything was haywire, everything was going crazy, in the midst of the tornado, inside the church, they were singing. These kids, these teachers, they were singing, Jesus loves me, and He's got the whole world in His hands. These are old hymns about Jesus loves me, this I know, and He's got the whole world in His hands. And they were just singing all throughout the 10, 15, 20 minutes as the tornado was destroying their whole church. Friends, I'm sharing you that this afternoon because maybe for some of you, you're right smack in the middle of a tornado in your life, where everything's going crazy, everything's going haywire, everything's getting destroyed and wrecked all around you, and you're just spinning round and round. If that's you today, let me just remind you that in the midst of your tornado, Jesus loves you and He's got your whole world at the palm of His mighty hands. And He is in control. He is protecting you, defending you, and strengthening you so that no matter what comes against you, you will stand and you will not fall. And all you have to do is to sing. All you have to do is lift up your voice, declare in faith that He is a God who protects, He is a God who defends, He is a God who is sovereign, He is a God that is holy, that is worthy. Come on, don't stop. That He is a God who saves, who heals, and He is the Lord of all. And we're gonna declare this once more. Come on, everybody sing it out loud. Believe it like you mean it. Sing it with all your heart.
In your name.
Come on.
We are saved, we are healed. In your name, we are free.
For all our days,
we will shout in victory. Jesus, you are Lord above. In your name, we are saved, we are healed. In your name.
Together we pray, today I receive all of God's love for me. Today I open myself to the unbounded, limitless, overflowing abundance of God's universe. Today I open myself to God's blessings, healing, and miracles. Today I open myself to God's word. so that I become more like Jesus every day. Today I proclaim that I'm God's beloved. I am God's servant. I am God's powerful champion. And because I am blessed, I am blessing the world in Jesus' name. Amen. Father, we're believing today that because it is Pentecost Sunday, it is Spirit Sunday, that you have something special in store for us, God. We're believing, Father, that as we come here today, we will be leaving changed, we will be leaving restored, renewed, and revived. So come have your way in these few moments that we have together. As we gather around your word, let your Spirit come to speak to us in a way that we need to be spoken to, that we will be led to change and be transformed, to really take hold of our lives and align it with yours. This is what we're believing, God. This is what we're hoping with our faith, expecting with our faith in these few moments that we have. So take over, God, as we sing.
Thy word is the lamp unto my feet and the light unto my path.
Come on, let's give the Lord a big hand. Hallelujah, Jesus, speak to us today. And before you get seated, our minute mingle as per usual, 60 seconds on the clock. Talk to someone you do not know. Ask them what they have in store for this upcoming week. Or talk whatever you want to talk about in 3, 2, 1, go. And you can give your partner a big hand and be seated. Hallelujah. Let's give a big hand to our worship team. Thank you very much, guys. Brother Ren from Feast Manila, marami pong salamat for playing for us today. Praise God. All right. I want to welcome those of you who came here for the very first time. Let's also honor them and give them a big hand. Come on. Thank you so much that you're here. We are glad and blessed. Maybe you feel weirded out of what's happening so far, but you're going to grow to love it, believe me. And God has brought you here for a purpose, I believe, to speak something into your life that will bless you for the days ahead. In fact, you can be already blessed even now. So thank you very much for coming. And for those of you who are watching online through Facebook Live, we are grateful and blessed that wherever you are, even if it's the opposite time, kahit baliktad yung oras, wherever you are in the globe, you are finding time to partake of God's word through our feast. So we are thankful and blessed. So I pray that this word be true to you. It will move your heart and move your life to continue to follow Jesus and bless the world, the society, the culture that you are in. So let's give them a big hand as well. Hallelujah. Who among you are feeling good? Raise your hand. Say, I'm good. I'm good. I'm good. Who among you are feeling not so good? Raise your hand. Be true. Magpakatotoo tayo. Sabi mo sa kanya, I'm gonna be better. All right. Very good. Okay. 3 years ago, great thing happened in my life. I got married. That's a great thing, right? Yes. And when we got married, of course, we have to live on our own already. So magsasarili na kami, di ba? And when we started moving into our place right now in our condo, we knew that we had to buy some appliances. And one of the first, or if not the first, major purchase I made for the house was this washing machine and dryer in one. And nung araw na yon, ang sakit sa puso. Yung parang, bibili ka na ng ganyan.
And I remember we were buying it, and in that moment, exactly as we were buying it, I felt literally I was growing older. I was adulting. Kasi dati ang ginagastos ko lang pagkain, pang-tol, pang-gimmick, ngayon washing machine na. Talagang tumatanda na tayo lahat. Buisit nga kanina may nagsabi sa akin, Mike, parang tito na yung forma mo ah. Minsan-minsan na lang ako magsuot ng ganito, di ba? But anyway, pwede ba? Pwede. Okay. Yes. Anyway, it's true. Totoo talaga yung sinasabi ng mga tao na napakabilis ng panahon. Tama ba? And life just goes by so quickly. Then once upon a time, I was in my single life, and then now I'm transitioning, and I have transitioned actually to my married life. And in that moment, I really remember it so much. After having bought that washing machine, it just sunk in, and life really goes on. And I'm sharing you that this afternoon because the title of our series is entitled Stages. Pakisabi nga, stages. In other words, we may find ourselves in different stages, in different seasons of life. A few weeks ago, I made mention of this, and that in the Philippines, we may not have four seasons, di ba? Sa mga ibang bansa, merong winter, spring, summer, and fall, right? Alam natin yan dahil sa kanta. Hindi natin nararamdaman dito kasi dito, two seasons lang, di ba? Hot and hotter, wet and wetter. Parang ngayon nga, dalawa yung summer, di ba? Init pa din. But really, even if here in the Philippines, we may not have four seasons, I believe our lives, our souls, our spiritual journey also goes through four powerful seasons. And in this series, Stages, we're gonna walk through those different seasons, those different stages, and find God where you are. In other words, we're gonna find God in the season that you're in, knowing that He is moving, He is orchestrating, He is molding you in that season so that we can align with Him, so that we can be more open to His purpose, plans, and power at work in that season. So that, everybody say, so that we can enjoy every age. Tingnan mo ngayong katabi mo. Anong age na ba niyan? Nag-i-enjoy ba yan sa edad niya? Or maybe for some of us, ito minsan napapansin ko, and I'm guilty of this, nung bata tayo, nagpapatanda tayo, di ba? Gusto natin, matanda na tayo, going with the big boys and all of that. Pero pag matanda na tayo, ayan na, saka tayo nagpapabata. Di ba? We've got to learn to enjoy every age. Amen? In fact, the Bible says this in Ecclesiastes chapter 3, verse 1. It says, there is a time for what? For everything. Meaning there is a God-ordained moment, time, okay, or sequence that your life has to go through. In fact, I believe the human journey, you can divide it into four stages. How many? Four stages. The first stage is, we could say, the first 20 years of your life. So 0 to 20. Who among you fall within this stage? Raise your hand. But yung iba nagtataas ang kamay, hindi naman. Can I hear a shout again from age 0 to 20? Okay. We've got young people in the house. See? May iba, woo! Sana ganun pa rin ako. See, this is the stage where the purpose of this stage is to explore. Everybody say explore. This is the time in our lives where we try to discover who we are, our values, our calling, our gifting, what we're good at, our character. And that's the whole purpose of this, that from that span of time in your age, or that age of 0 to 20, you're discovering your values, your identity, and you're discovering who you are. Once upon a time, there was this husband and wife. They've been married for 20 years at may tatlo na silang anak. One day, si husband lumapit kay wife at sabi niya sa wife, nabigla si wife kasi hindi niya na, she didn't see this coming. Sabi ni husband, dear, I'm sorry. It's not you, it's what? It's me. Alam na alam niyo na. I'm leaving you and I'm doing this for myself. So gulat si ate, gulat na gulat si wife. What? What happened? What's wrong? Why are you leaving me? O, di ba, pang MMMK, di ba? So, pwede na. konti pa. Anyway, bakit? And so, the husband said, again, it's not you, it's me. I'm leaving you because I have to find myself. Diba? Sabi ng wife, wow, find yourself ka dyan. 45 years old ka na, may tatlo ka pang anak, may nalalaman ka pang find yourself. Sige, tutulungan kita. Honey, nandito ka ba? Honey, nandyan ka ba? Find yourself ka dyan. Thank you. Married people in the house, raise your hand. Okay, make sure that at this time, you have already found yourself, all right? But for those of you who are young, are youth, and are singles, are you here? Okay, hear me loud and clear, all right? Hear me loud and clear. Single people, meaning if you're not yet married, okay? Both youth and singles. Singles must find themselves when they're single. Yes? So that you won't experience horrific marital stories like that. Okay? You have to find who you are, discover who you are at that stage, at that level. So finding oneself must be done in stage one. All right? Second stage is this. This is the next 20 years of life. So ito na. For kung kanina 0 to 20, who among you here fall under 20 to 40? Nandito na rin ako. Raise your hand. Yan, di ba? Lahat tayo. May iba pa rin, parang sinungaling. Di ba? 20 to 40. Now, in this phase, in this stage, the purpose here is to expand. Everybody say expand. This is the time now that you've discovered yourself, you've discovered your gifting, your calling, your identity, your values, and it's time to expand. It's time to develop your character. Develop your calling, develop your capacity, your abilities. It's the time in your life where you enter into new territories. That's why we call it expand. All right? Next stage to this is now the next 20 years. So, kung kanina 0 to 20, 20 to 40, ito na ang ating golden 40 to 60. Taas sa kamay, sino nandyan? Yan! Be proud! Let's give them a big hand! So this is now the stage of life where the ultimate goal, the ultimate purpose is to be exact. Pakisabi nga exact. In other words, you've got to zero in. You need to focus in to that specific mission or calling that God has for your life. And this is the time where you need to somehow use the influence that God is giving you to impact the world around you. So you need to be exact. Hindi na yung finding yourself, hindi na yung so much of trying new things, but you're zeroing in to that one thing that God is using you for in this life. And of course, how many stages have we discussed? Three, right? The last one, so kung yung third is 40 to 60, the last phase of life, this is the 60 onwards. Huwag na natin bigyan ng cup kasi baka pinapatay natin kagad, di ba? Huwag naman ganun. 60 onwards. Who among you fall in this? Raise your hand. Yan, yan ang palakpakan natin. Yan ang i-honor natin. Yan. Thank you, brother. Thank you, tita. This is the stage or the season of life where the whole goal is now to exit. Okay? And what I mean by exit is when you now begin to pass on the baton. You now begin to empower the people around you or beneath you. And this is the time where you work out trying to leave a lasting legacy that will bless your family, that will bless your world. So these are the four different stages, phases of life. And throughout this series, we're going to take one Sunday per stage. All right? So this Sunday, we're going to talk about the first stage. So 0 to 20. But if you don't fall within that age range, do not worry, because I believe there are still some things that we can learn from people going through that journey, going through that phase that we can apply in our lives today. Do you believe that? Say amen. Amen. So the first stage is, again, explore. And what I'm going to do in this series is that apart from preaching every message, I'm going to invite someone who is in that exact season to co-preach the message with me, to bring that season alive. Para may example talaga, para malapit sa puso niya, yung sinasabi niya, and it's something real to a lot of us. So that's what I'm gonna start to do today. So I invited a good friend of ours. He proclaims to be a very handsome guy, which I also believe. Do not worry, okay? He's one of our musical directors. He used to be one of the top leaders in the youth ministry where I grew up in, all right? And he, by profession, is in the IT industry and also a financial advisor. You'll be blessed by his humor, by his wisdom and stories. Please welcome Brother Kaloy Likup.
Lakas! Ang ganda ng picture. Yeah. Good morning, beautiful... Ay, good afternoon pala. Good afternoon, beautiful people of Feast! Alright. So, nagulat kayo. So, ako nga po ulit si Kaloy. And you may know me as a member of the music ministry. Yung nakikita niyo nakikeyboard dyan minsan. Ako po yung pinakyut dun sa music ministry. Alam niyo naman po yun, di ba? Amen. Amen. Okay. Sige. So, so today, sabi nga ni Kuya Mike, we'll be talking about the first stage of life. So may I hear once again all the young people in the house? Woohoo! Dami ulit sinungaling, pero okay lang yan. Di ba? So, itong talk natin today would be tungkol sa first 20 years of your life. And kaya po ako yung pinili ni Kuya Mike kasi kaka-graduate ko lang po sa first stage ng aking life. So, wag na po kayong umangal, 22 lang po ako. Okay? Okay, sige. And the whole throughout this series, we will be talking about life of David as the model of these four stages. Ilan ulit yung stages? Ano yung pag-uusapan natin? The first. Okay, good job. Okay. So, okay lang po ba mag-co-preach ako today? Okay lang? Okay, nice. Okay. So now, let's talk about David. As a young shepherd boy, kasi your first stage, diba? So, let's talk about David as the young shepherd boy. Pakisabi, young shepherd boy. And we know David, the young shepherd boy, bilang yung tao na kumalaban kay Goliath, yes. And gusto ko alam muna i-take note ninyo. Si David po, hindi po siya inutusan na kalabanin si Goliath. Si David po, siya po ang nag-volunteer. And sabi ko nga, young shepherd boy pa siya. So, yung mga tao nun, nagdududa kay David. Kasi di ba si Goliath, malaking tao. Si David nung time na yun, bansot na maliit, di ba? And isa doon sa mga tao na nagda-doubt sa kanya ay si King Saul. At ito ang sinabi ni King Saul. How could you fight him? You're just a boy. And he has been a soldier all his life. Di ba? You're just a boy. Bata ka lang, di ba? Sino ba dito gustong sinasabihan na bata ka lang? Siguro yung mga matatanda, gusto nila yun. Pero yung mga bata, di ba? Ayaw nila. Kasi parang minamaliit tayo yung mga bata. And tulad natin, si David, ayaw din niya na sinabihan siya noon. So ito naman ang sagot ni David. Your Majesty, I take care of my father's sheep, and anytime a lion or a bear carries off a lamb, I go after it, attack it, and rescue the lamb. And if the lion or bear turns on me, I grab it by the throat and beat it to death. I have killed lions and bears, and I will do the same to this heathen Philistine who has defied the army of the living God. The Lord has saved me from the lions and bears, and He will save me from this Philistine. So bakit nga ba nagduda ang hari? Diba? Aside from David being young, nabanggit ko nga na si David ay isang pastol. And ano ba ibig sabihin nun? Explain ko muna, ano bang ginagawa ng isang pastol? 99% of the time, boring yung buhay ng pastol. Ano ba ginagawa ng pastol? Papanorin lang niya, buong araw, yung mga sheep o yung mga tupa na kumain at matulog buong araw. Tingnan ang katabi. Wala na bang ginawa yan kundi kumain at matulog buong araw? Di ba? Yun. So buong araw yun lang ginagawa ng shepherd. Pero ito na, 1% of the time, ito na yung exciting part ng pagiging shepherd. Pag may lumalabas na lion, bear, or wolf, ito trabaho ni shepherd. Siya ang mamamagitan between predator and the prey. And kung kailangan patayin yung predator, Di ba? Papatayin niya, di ba? Sino dito nakapatay na ng lion? Wala pa. Sino dito nakapatay na ng bear? Wala pa. Sino nakapatay na ng ipis? Woo, dami. Praise God, nakapatay tayo ng ipis. Yeah. So yun. So nung si David ay isang batang pastor pa lamang, malamang sa malamang, walang-wala siyang idea na gagamitin ni Lord yung experience niya as a young shepherd boy to use it against dun sa fight ng buhay niya, which is yung fight niya against kay Goliath. And friends, listen here. This is what I want to tell you today. Just like David, in the first stage of your life, God was already there preparing for your calling. Pero ito ang problem natin, di ba? Ayaw natin ng boring. Ayaw natin ng ordinaryo. Gusto natin exciting. Sino dito gusto ng exciting? Di ba lahat tayo? Pero gusto kong makinig kayo ulit. Kasi kung nasa ng ordinaryo, naroroon ang Diyos. God is found in your ordinary. So sa mga young people today, what does God want you to do today? He wants you to be faithful in your ordinary. Diba? Pakisabi sa katabi, be faithful in your ordinary. Okay. So, ito, may sinabi din si Jesus about this. Diba? Let's all read together. Yan. Whoever is faithful in small matters will be faithful in what? Large ones. Diba? Para lang yan nung bata ka. Diba? Sino dito may lababo sa bahay? Sino dito? Wala kayong lababo sa bahay? Ha? Sino dito may lababo sa bahay? Sino dito? Diba? Natatandaan nyo ba na nung bata kayo, gustong-gusto nyong maabot yung lababo na hindi nyo maabot, diba? Bebuelo pa kayo, pero wala talaga. Pero nung lumaki na kayo, diba, abutin nyo yung lababo. Pero ayaw nyo na kasi takot na kayo maghugas ng pinggan. Ngayon mga magulang, tignan ang mga anak. Hawakan ang anak at sabihin, be faithful in your small matters. Alright. Okay lang ba magkwento? Okay. Wala naman kayong magagawa eh. Okay. Sige. Share ko lang yung dream ko nung bata ako. Nung ako'y 7 years old pa lang. Nung ako'y bata pa. Ito. Itong pangarap ko na to, pinangarap ng marami din. Iilan sa atin. Nung bata po ako, pinangarap ko maging WWE wrestler. Ayan, kita nyo naman, ayan. So nung bata ako, sobrang fan ko ng wrestling. Eh yung mama ko, OFW ng Canada yan. So pwede siyang bumili ng yung maskara ni Rey. Pakita nyo ulit, di ba? Pakita nyo ulit. Yung ayan, di ba? Kita nyo yung maskara ni Rey Mysterio. Sobrang ate ko sa wrestling, nagpabili ako sa mama ko. Mama, bilan mo ako ng maskara ni Rey Mysterio tsaka yung belt, ganyan. Ganun ako ka-spoiled. So sobrang adik ko sa wrestling, pinagpa-practicean ko yung pinsan ko. Doon sa kama, nagre-wrestling kami. As in, marami na kaming kamang nasira. Pati yung sa lolo ko nasira. And eto na. So sobrang adik ko sa wrestling, kumuha ako ng homemade na wrestling video. As in, production value. As in, makikita nyo kung gaano ka-professional ginawa tong wrestling video. Pwede ba natin pakita? Yeah. Hulaan nyo na lang kung saan ako dyan. Diba?
Oh no! Kaloy fell on the floor!
Diba? Oh, feel na feel. Oh, oh, oh.
Oh, sakit!
Diba? May sound effects pa, diba? Sinong gusto ng sample? Yeah, sinong gusto masampalan? Sino? Obviously, hindi po yun yung calling ko. Hindi naman ako naging wrestler, di ba? Hindi porket macho ako ngayon, naging wrestler ako. So, what exactly is God's calling for me? What does God want me to do? So fast forward tayo onte. When I was 13 years old. And that was the time when I first met the Lord. Yun po yung una kong pag-attend ng prayer meeting. Doon nga po sa community na pinanggalingan namin ni Kuya Mike. Doon sa youth ministry ng Bukas Loob sa Diyos community. And bago pa ako makapasok sa venue, naririnig ko na yung, kala ko late ako eh. Pero may naririnig na akong banda, ganun. So kala ko late na ako. Pagdating ko, sobrang aga ko pala. And nagre-rehearse lang pala sila. And ako, nanonood lang ako sa band. And habang nakaupo ako doon, nung tinitingnan ko yung band, I felt like God was talking to me. I felt a great impact in my heart. And the worship started, the people started worshiping, and during the worship, God was talking to me again. And I don't know why I was very bothered, and why I was really... Hirap mag-English. Diba? Ulitin ko yung English ko. Charot. De. Diba? Nung tinitingnan ko yung banda, as in, kinakausap talaga ako ni Lord. Today, 9 years later, I am now a musician for God. I now serve as a keyboardist and I now serve as a musical director here in the Feast Bellevue PM. But friends, let me just tell you, during those 9 years, it was very, very ordinary. It started out very ordinary. Kasi noong mga first few years na ako po ay nag-start na mag-serve as a keyboardist, yung prayer meetings po namin, siguro marami na ang 30 people na uma-attend. And it was very ordinary because our equipment was ordinary. Iba pa nga, sira. Maraming technical difficulties, yung mics kinakalawang, and all that. But through those few years, through those 9 years, God taught me to be humble and God purified my motives. And, excuse me. And today, sabihin ko po sa inyo, wrestler po ako today. Bakit ako wrestler? Because I am wrestling using God's word today as your preacher. And I would just want to tell you that this is my first time to preach today. And I praise God for that. I'm a wrestler today. Yes. So now, I want to speak to the young people now. May I hear again from my young people? Okay. Let me tell you this. God is with you. And He has been preparing you for your calling. If you are in a boring or ordinary moment, declare it with me. God is right here, right now. God is right here, right now, working through you. God is right here, right now. He's doing everything just to mold you to become great in the future. Do you believe that you will be great in the future? Yes? Amen? Amen. Let's say that again. God is right here, right now. Let's say that again with conviction. God is right here, right now. Let's say that again, please. Amen. And today, God is planting seeds for your great harvest tomorrow. Do you claim that? And even God says it in the Word. If you are young, listen to this verse. Don't let anyone look down on you because you are young, but set an example for the believers in speech, in conduct, in love, in faith, and in purity. Utos ng Diyos yan sa'yo kung bata ka. Wag na wag mo nga hayaan na sasabihin na bata ka lang. Wag na wag mo nga hayaan na magduda sila sa iyo kasi hindi ka bata lang. You're not just a child. You are a child of God. Amen. And God will use you mightily if you stay faithful in your ordinary because you are a child of God. Amen. Tap 5 people and tell them you are a child of God. So may I now call on Kuya Mike back on the stage. Maraming salamat po. Pagpalain kayo ng Diyos.
Amen. Sino yung idol mo ng bata ka na wrestler? Si Rey Mysterio?
Si Rey Mysterio.
Sige, bakit?
Kasi feeling ko matatas doon tumalon, ganun. Pero mataba talaga ako.
Kaya inisip ko hindi... Kaya naisip ko hindi si Rey Mysterio yun, eh, parang si Bam Bam Bigelow.
Ay, di ko na naabutan yun.
Ay, okay.
Yung panahon mo, iba na eh. Sorry, ha?
magaling. Hallelujah. Nahalata tuloy, ano? Amen. Oh, sige na, let's recover. Okay. So, 4 stages of life, and across those 4 stages, things would be different. But I'll tell you, there are 2 things across those 4 stages that will never change. All right, two things that never change in all the stages of your life. The first one is this, your ultimate purpose. See, each stage will have its distinct purpose. God will have a distinct purpose for your life in that specific stage. But your ultimate purpose, no matter what the stage would be, will always be the same. And it is this, to grow your spirit. Friends, the truth is, the real measure of success, who among you want to be successful? Raise your hand. All right, we all do, yes? The real measure of success is not how big your house would be, or how fat your bank account is, or how many likes you have on Facebook, or how many plaques you have on the wall. The real measure of success will always be your spiritual growth and your relationships. Because at the end of the day, that is what matters. Your character and your ability to love. This reminds me, of course, this is something relevant that we see recently. This reminds me of the story of Aladdin. A whole new world. Ako yun yung gusto ko dati maging boy band, yung ganyan. A dazzling place I never knew. Tama ba? Way up here. Oh, anyway, never mind. Halatang hindi yun yung calling ko. Hindi. Okay. So, sino sa inyo nakapanood nung, eto ah, sino sa inyo nakapanood nung animated film? Taas ang kamay. Sino sa inyo nakapanood nung live action version? Okay. So, I won't care for spoilers anymore, ha? Kasi nung 90s pa, alam nyo na kung ano yung storya. Diba? Alam natin yan. Ilang wish yung binigay ni Genie kay Aladdin? Ilan? Tatlo. Okay? Three wishes. And if you remember, the genie was so surprised that Aladdin did not know what to wish. So binigyan niya ng mga top hits. Ito yung sabi niya, mga popular wishes of those who rub the lamp. Sabi niya, it's usually money, power, prestige, popularity, or position. Ilan lang yan sa mga yan. Yan yung top hits. Yan yung usually pinipili ng mga tao. And what did Aladdin ask for? He wanted to be a prince. Right? He wanted to be a prince to impress, to get noticed by a princess. Technically, what he wished for was position. He wanted to be a prince, again, to get noticed by Jasmine, by Princess Jasmine. And that position came with it, the money, the power, the prestige, the popularity. And so, wish granted, he becomes a prince. Nakilala siya ni princess. At a certain point of the story, as the story progresses, he somehow gets a grip of himself and he realizes that he's not being true to himself, nor is he being true to the people around him. So somehow, you see that he's growing in character. Kasi natauhan siya. And at some point, he decided, against his will or his own plans, he decided that he will let go of becoming a prince. So you see the transformation. In fact, he even showed how he grew in selflessness. Bakit? Because remember, his last and final wish was what? Was to set the genie free. And it wasn't anymore about him. It was more about another person. Friends, let me ask you, let's just be real. Who among you here, I asked you already, you want it to be a success, but who among you wants to be a financial success? Raise your hand. We all do. Who among you wants to be, let's say, a billionaire, millionaire? Taas ang, wala namang masama mangarap. Okay, good. Let's say, yes, you want to become a billionaire. But in the process of becoming that billionaire, you become a jerk, you become arrogant, you become that bad person who looks down on other people. In the process of becoming that billionaire, when you become that jerk, your billions will not mean anything. That's why, regardless of what you get out of this life, in every season of life, the bottom line question is this. If the ultimate goal, if the ultimate purpose is the growth of our spirit, the bottom line question is this. And you've got to ask yourself this. Every season of life, am I becoming more selfless? Are you growing across the different seasons of life, are you growing in your capacity, in your character? Are you growing towards the character of Christ? Are you becoming more kind, more compassionate, more generous, more loving, more courageous even, and more humble? So that's the first thing that never changes throughout the different stages and seasons of life. Our ultimate what? Our ultimate purpose. Number two is this. The second thing that never changes is our underlying perspective. Everybody say perspective. See, every computer, whether it be a personal computer or your smartphone, they all run with an operating system. Tama ba? So, for example, if you are an Apple user, you have the Mac OS. Or if not, you probably have it in Windows, right? In your smartphone, dalawa lang naman yan most of the time. It's either your iOS, which is your Apple phone, or an Android phone, yes? So we all know this. All of these things run through an operating system. And why am I bringing this up? Because people are like computers. People are like computers. We all have a basic underlying operating system that quietly works in the background, that quietly works behind the scenes, but it gives guidance to how we think, how we speak, and how we act. It's our default mechanism. That's our operating system. And for most people, sadly, they have two operating systems that they run on in life. Across the different stages, ito yung paano nila ina-approach ang buhay. The first one, or I'll give you the two, okay? The two operating systems that most common people run on in terms of their lives are this. First is, a lot of people live in their past. LYP, okay? And for others, they live in their future. LYF, so life and life. Okay? Living in your past, living in your future. Let's talk about the first one. Living in your past. People who live in their past, ito yung mga paborito nilang phrases. Okay? This is the thing that they always find themselves saying. And maybe you're the same. Let's see, okay? And these are some phrases. They would usually say, when I was young, during our time, alam mo nung panahon namin? Or, those were the good old days. Sino sa'yo nagsasalita ng mga yan? Wala na ngayon, di ba? Oh, biglang, hindi ako yan. And sometimes, I'm growing older as well, so sometimes I get to say this. And so people who have this OS, this operating system of living in their past, they usually think this way. They think that everything in the past is good, and everything modern is bad. One time, I was sitting in a coffee shop. I was finishing out my talk, and I didn't mean to eavesdrop on the other table, but I couldn't help it because ang lakas ng boses nila. Across my table, naka-earphones na ako noon na nagtatrabaho. Introvert kasi ako. Ayoko makipag-usap sa mga tao. Ganyan. Pero narinig ko talaga sila. And the other table, and they were, how do I say it? They were titas of Manila. Yung ganon. Puro mga tita. Ganyan. No offense. And this is what I heard them say. Sabi nila, grabe talaga yung mga bata ngayon. Yung mga yan, wala nang ginawa kundi mag-Facebook. Yung mga millennial na yan, mga Gen Z na yan, walang ginawa kundi mag-chat-chat-chat. Chat-chat-chat-chat. Ganyan. Kaya pansin nyo, sabi mo, kaya pansin mo, Mare, hindi na sila marunong makipag-usap sa mga tao na maayos. Hindi sila marunong makipag-usap ng tao sa harapan. Kaya buti pa tayo, di ba? Wala nga tayong Facebook nun. Pero tayo nakakapag-usap ng maayos. So they said so many different things, bashing this current generation. And when they were saying this, I wanted to, of course I didn't, but I wanted to somehow butt in politely. Kasi syempre, builder ako, di ba? Hindi mo pwede, huy, ganyan. I wanted to, ito lang yung naisip ko, ito na lang. This reminded me of my friend, my good friend, Bene Sanchez. Okay, you know him as the son of Brother Bo. We hang out pretty often because of feast worship and because we're cool like that. Yes, wala lang. Anyway, so I remember him because this is a guy who uses a lot of social media, but he uses it to bring people closer to the Lord. He communicates to his different friends, to the different people he is discipling, to be able to schedule coffee dates. And he goes on these coffee dates almost every day, just simply discipling one-on-one or 1-3 or 1-4, 1-5, leading small Bible studies, leading these people closer to Jesus. My point is that for the older people, they thought all of this is evil, all of this technological advancement, social media and all, but this is a man who's harnessing all of that to advance the gospel and to build God's kingdom. In fact, sadly, there are a lot of people today, there are people who operate in that live in your past mindset where they think or they demonize or criticize anything that's new. Kahit anong bago ay galing sa devil yan. Yan ang automatic default nila because that's their operating system. And it's sad. Are you listening? Yes? It's sad that there are certain articles going around written by maybe some religious leaders who say that all of social media is demonic. Now, if that is true, then these people who believe so will have to tell Pope Francis, His Holiness, that what he's doing is demonic. Because if you've checked, Pope Francis has a Facebook account, an official Facebook account, an IG account, a Twitter account, and a YouTube channel. In fact, if you do your history, if you study history, you will see that when something new came about, people were shocked, people thought it was from the devil. If you remember, and this is, eto, hindi ko na to naabutan, Kaloy, ha? Kaya, hindi na ako to. When the TV came into the picture, sino sa inyo naka-experience yun yung first time nagkaroon ng TV sa mundo, taas ang kamay? Ayan, si sister, ayan, ito yung mga nasa fourth stage of life, di ba? Okay, when the TV came in the scene, people called it the devil's invention, and they were campaigning people now to go back to the radio. But also, the radio itself, nung nagkaroon ng radyo, siguro wala na nakaabot nun, no? But nung nagkaroon ng radyo, people were also saying that that is an invention of the devil, imploring people to go back into their old-fashioned newspapers instead. So here's my point. These things, these are new advancements that come into our society, come into our culture, and there are good, it's neutral, all right? It's neutral. There's a good side to it, there's a bad side to it. It depends on how it is used. And so, as followers of Christ, if these things are brought to us, we'd rather use it for the glory of God, yes? I mean, it can be used for evil, and we've seen it. Fake news and all of these other things, but let's continue to use it, let's harness it for the glory of God in advancing His kingdom. Because we don't want to just simply live in our past, and I'll tell you later on, we want to live in our now and use it for now. Amen? Now, I'll do this quickly because I'm losing time. There's another kind of people who continue to live in their past. And these are people who maybe have been traumatized because of their past, and they are now prisoners of past pain. And I'll just rattle off a quick examples that maybe you and I can relate with. There was this woman once who, whenever she looks at the mirror, all that she sees in the mirror is a broken-hearted woman who was left by a man who she gave her life to. And that's all that she sees whenever she looks at the mirror, a broken-hearted woman, even if that happened 6 years ago. There's this businessman who failed in 3 of his businesses and he can't seem to move on because in his mind, he's a failure. Or this girl who you could say would be pretty, who looks like someone who parang lumabas ng magazine or came out of a billboard, and yet all her adult life, she feels and she thinks she's ugly. Because all the time when she was growing up, her father and her siblings called her ugly. Friends, these are people who have been paralyzed by their past. And maybe you feel the same way, that you have been enslaved by your past, that you have been chained up, you have been held captive by your past. And so if that's you, and to anyone who continues to operate in that mindset, in that operating system of living in your past, this is God's word for you today, and maybe you will be set free by this. It is His word to the prophet Isaiah, and it says this, "Forget the former things. Do not dwell on the past. See, I am doing a new thing." Friends, it is time to get past your past and see the good and great things, the new things God is doing in your life now. It's time to open your eyes to see the new and great things God is doing in your life right now. So the first operating system that a lot of people work with is living in your past. I'll do the second one quickly. The second is living in your future. And I can relate to this a lot because I am a planner. Okay? I plan things in my life. So at the start of the year, I plan my whole year. At the start of the month, I already plan the next month. My wife knows this and it drives her crazy because we have to live by our calendar. And if it doesn't, mag-aaway tayo. Na joke lang. And so I start out the week and I plan out my week. So I'm a planner. I always look ahead and plan far ahead into the future, which makes me prone and susceptible to this operating system, living in your future. But there's a downside to this. There is a side effect to this, and it's called worry. Worry. And I'll be honest with you, in this season of our lives where we're planning to build a family, I get worried. I spend sleepless nights. Wala pa nga kaming anak, di ba? I get worried of how I'll provide well for my family, for my kids. I get worried of how to put them to school. I get worried if I'm gonna be a good father or not. I even get worried how to get this woman pregnant. I worry. I'm a warrior. And so if you're like me, and this is your struggle, and that God is working in you, if you're like me, and this is your struggle, that you worry about the future, you and I need to help each other to catch ourselves whenever we fall into worry. Because get this, okay, listen. Worry will never allow you to enjoy the present moment. You will lose out on what God is doing in that moment when you worry. So friends, we need to start living. Oh, sorry, before I say that, this is what Jesus says. It says here in Matthew chapter 6, verse 34. Can you read it all together? 1, 2, 3, go. "Therefore, do not be anxious about tomorrow, for tomorrow will be anxious for itself. Sufficient for the day is its own trouble." And we need to balance this out because in the book of Lamentations, it says, "The steadfast of the Lord never ceases. It is new every morning." So yes, Jesus, what he's saying is true, that yes, every day has its own trouble, has its own trial, has its own problems. And we should not be anxious for tomorrow because every day has a set of problems. But God also says that in each new day, there is fresh blessing, there is fresh mercy, there is fresh anointing, there is fresh and new blessing. So we need to live in our now. You need to live in your now. See, sometimes we go to an event. We go to an event, let's say, or you go to a foreign place and you're a tourist there. What happens? And maybe some of you does this. What happens? All throughout the time, you end up taking so many pictures, so many videos, and you're just taking pictures the whole while, the whole time that you're there. And usually when that happens, we miss out on what's happening, on that beautiful moment that is transpiring right before our very eyes. And we take hundreds of photos, and get be honest with me. And maybe for some of you this is true, that in your phone are hundreds of photos you never saw again after you took it. True or true? Diba? Pagdating kasi natin, "Hoy, picture tayo dyan, ganyan." And all the while through, we're just taking pictures and we miss out on the full experience of that place, of that moment. And so may I suggest to you that whenever you get to travel next time or you be with friends, All right, yeah, take a few photos, maybe 1, 2, 3 tops, and then put it back on your pocket so that you can savor the moment, so that you can drink it all in, sink it all in, so that when you go home, you don't go home with a bunch of useless photos. You go home with an experience. You go home with a memory of joy. Amen? Makes sense? Very practical, yes? Let's do this quick. See, embracing your present, I know it's tough. For me, it's tough as well. I'm preaching this to myself. It's tough because the pull of the past and the pull of the present will always be there. But you and I, we have got to learn to find God in what is in front of us. You need to learn to find God in what's in front of you now. In the book of Exodus, when God revealed himself to Moses in the burning bush, Moses asked for his name, and God said, I am who am. Or in other versions, it says, I am who I am. Notice, he did not say, I was who I was, or I will who I will be. He said, I am who I am. And one of the interpretations, one of the meanings of this phrase was that God is saying, I am here now. I am here with you now. So friends, live in your now. Live in your now and let God turn every moment of your life to a God moment. No matter how ordinary, let him turn that moment into a God moment, filled with blessing, filled with healing, filled with miracles in that God moment. So stop living in your past and stop living in your future. Start living in your now. And in your now, you will discover that God is right here, right now. And that God is always in your now. Amen. Let's all stand. I started this message this afternoon by sharing with you a story of a church that was hit by a tornado. Today, let me share with you, as I end, a story now of a church that caught on fire. Maybe you saw this in the news. Last April 15, 2019, the cathedral, the famous cathedral of Notre Dame, caught fire because of complications in its renovation. And because of the fire, the whole roof was destroyed and it collapsed going in, and everything was messed up and wrecked. But after the fire, there was this photo that surfaced on the internet, and it showed this, that in the midst of the rubble, in the midst of the devastation, in the midst of the destruction, you can clearly see, we can clearly see that the cross still stands, that the cross still stands strong. And I'm making mention of this right now because for some of you, as I was preaching earlier and telling you that you've got to live in your now, you're probably thinking, Mike, how can I live in my now? Because my now feels like that fire. My now feels like I'm in that fiery furnace of my trials, of my problems, that I'm feeling the heat of persecution, of suffering. And so yes, maybe you're like those three guys in Daniel chapter 3 when they were thrown into the fiery furnace and they're being persecuted and they're being hurt. And maybe you feel the same way, that you're going through hell right now in your life. Let me just tell you, friends, that in that story, if you remember, there was a fourth man in the flame. That in those, with those three guys, there was a fourth man in that fiery furnace. And so I believe that today, as you go through, as you experience the fiery furnace that you're facing right now, I believe there with you is another fourth man. There with you is that person with you, standing next to you, for there is another in the fire. There is another in the fire. And that name, that person in that fire is Jesus. Amen? And because He is with you in that fire, you will not be burned. You will not be consumed. In fact, as the cross stands today, now and forever, you in the midst of that fire, in the midst of that trial, you and I will stand strong, unscathed, unharmed by the flames. Because there's another in the fire. Because there's another in the fire. Believe it today that Jesus is with you in your now. Jesus is with you in your fire, in your trouble, in your crisis. God is in your now. He is with you. And if you believe this today, I can invite you to lift up your hands like this, if this is something comfortable for you. Just close your eyes with me and just feel the presence of God right at your midst, right here, right now, right beside you. He knows what you're going through. He knows the fire that you are going through, that you're trying to put out, that is circling you right now in this life. Come and surrender to Him today as we pray. Lord Jesus, we thank You that in the heat of the flame, You are with us, protecting us, shielding us, empowering us to be stronger than whatever fire that we're facing. So continue, Lord, molding us, purifying us through the fire. And we know and believe that when this fire subsides, we will stand strong, we will stand faithful, we will stand with You. For You are strong and You are faithful in our lives. In Jesus' name. Come on, in Jesus' name. In Jesus' name, we say, there is another. There's another in the fire. Standing next to me, there is another. Another.
Come on, give Him praise. Hallelujah. We praise You, God. We praise You.
So no matter how difficult the pull of the past or the pull of the future may be, God is calling you to live in the present, to live in your now. No matter how difficult, because you can bet that He is always with you, no matter what fire you face. Amen. If you believe this today, I can invite you to be an encouragement to someone. There's someone right around you that needs this. Tell that person with a handshake or with a hug, God is with you. 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 Let's give the Lord a mighty shout of praise. Hallelujah. You can be seated. To lead us in our giving, He is our singles ministry head here at Feast Bellevue PM. You'll be hearing from him actually next week as well as we talk about the next stage of life. Please welcome Brother Don Villapando.
Therefore, tapos na. Therefore lang agad eh. Can I encourage everybody na i-lift natin yung LO envelope natin? Thank you, thank you. Originally, yung mga gantong size ng envelope, ginagamit siya pag magsusulat ka sa mga mahal natin sa buhay, kapag susulatan natin sila pag nasa abroad. Sino mga nakaabot doon? Yan, naikwento lang yun sa akin eh. Kidding aside, I love, nung naaalala ko yun, yung mga moments na bibigyan ako ni mami ng yellow paper, na magsimula na ako mag-start magsulat para kay tatay. My father is working as a musician. Banda tatay ko. Magaling siya magbanda. Doon, magpapasalamat ako. Thank you, tay, sa mga pinadala mo, sa mga packages mo. Maraming salamat sa bagong sasakyan. Diba? Uumpisahan ko na siyang diligan so it grows. Then, during those time, hindi ako yung tipo na nahingi sa kanya. Kasi he really provides. Naiiya ako magsabi sa kanya. Pero one part of it that I really love is when I tell him yung mga accomplishments ko. Tay, eto, honor na naman ako. Tapos, nasa section A ulit ako. Hindi niya alam, isang section lang kami. Then, just like this envelope. Just like this LO envelope. Makikita natin, meron ditong Thanksgiving. Ama, maraming salamat. Binigay mo sa akin to. Pinagkalooban mo ako na ito. Maraming salamat kasi hindi mo ako pinapabayaan. The prayer intention, Ama, not like my earthly father kung saan nahihiya ako magsabi sa kanya ng pangangailangan ko. Dito, we are encouraged na magsabi talaga kay Lord. Nasa Bible yon, ask and you shall receive. Ama, ito yung mga pangarap ko eh. Tulungan mo naman ako. Ama, pwede mo bang pagalingin si ganito, si ganyan? Then, nung bata kasi ako, as a proof of my accomplishment, nag-i-insert ako ng mga picture. Ng picture ko na wearing my medals, na, kumbaga, during my graduation, dito, ang picture natin, this will serve as our proof of our accomplishments. Ama, ito yung nagawa ko. Or better say, ito yung nagawa natin. Kasi I really can't do this on my own. Why 10%? Nasa Bible yon. 10%. Ngayon, bro, you may say, bro, ang hirap. It is so hard for me to say yes in giving kasi sapat lang eh. But, hear me on this. At the start of this year, I am troubled in my job. Tapos, sobrang stress up until now naman. And this pillar of our community asked me to lead singles ministry. And it just reminds me of, parang sort of, reminding me of me being a yes man to him. So, okay, okay, Lord. Yes, and that really opens the gate of heaven to various opportunities. I meet new friends and be more able to appreciate simple blessings. Doon pumasok yung realization ko. Minsan pala, hindi tayo nagkukulang ng blessing. Nagkukulang lang tayo ng pusong marunong magpasalamat. Marunong magpasalamat na, Lord, sa kabila ng lahat ng nangyayari sa akin, ikaw to. Dahil sa iyo to. At hindi mo ako babayaan. And by the way, at the start of the year, up until last week, nakapagpa-award po ako ng 5 new projects sa isa sa pinakamalaking construction company here in the Philippines. And I am I'm about to be promoted, sabi nila. Please be encouraged. The picture, yung love offering nilalagay natin dito, will be form part of this community of serving other people, of making people feel God's love. And in our most humblest way, we're able to bring really heaven on earth. Thank you.
Amen. Amen. Praise God. Brother Don and Sister Flo both co-lead our singles ministry, and they're doing amazing things reaching our single people for the glory of God. Let's give him another big hand. Thank you so much. Let's do this quickly. We want to welcome again those of you who came here for the very first time. Let's give them a big hand again. Thank you so much. After the final song, you can head towards that side of the hall with our welcome ministry. We want to give you a welcome gift, and we want to get to know you better as well and connect with you. Also, and I'm glad and proud to announce this, we want to honor our recent Lux graduates, our Lux couples graduates. This is our couples retreat that we do, I think, every twice or thrice each year. And these are our Lux couples graduates. Can we invite you to stand just to honor you guys? Come on, can we invite you to stand and just give them a big hand? Sige, okay, mahiya. Amen. Any more? I think there are some as well. And we're going to pray over them in a few moments. But I just want to say that really the feast is for the family. We have programs to be able to really reach out to people in every walk of life, in every stage of life. And so we're glad that here our couples are also growing in their marriage, in their family, and in their relationship with the Lord. So let's say, extend our hands over them and let's just pray. Heavenly Father, we thank you for the wonderful things that you're doing in the lives of these couples, in the lives of these families. We know that this is the seed that will begin a brand new life for them, filled with love, joy, and peace, that their family, their household will be prosperous, it will grow in abundance, but most of all, their household will serve you as you say in your word. So we thank you for what you're doing now in their lives. In Jesus' name, amen. Thank you so much, guys. You can be seated. Sister Green.
So if the couples were blessed at the Lux retreat, we have a retreat also for all the singles, those who are not yet married. Sino mga single dito? Ayan. So we also have a retreat for you. It's called the Love Life Retreat. And again, we want to invite you to this and be blessed. This will be on June 29 to 30 at St. James Retreat House in Tagaytay. And our investment fee is 3,000, which includes food, accommodation, and transportation. Ayan. So please do invite your friends also to come to this retreat and be blessed. Visit also the info bar for more details. And can I hear a shout from all the beautiful women in the house? Ayan, lakas. Who were there at the Jewels Conference last week? Ayan. Praise God, you were all blessed. And here's to remind you again of our experience at the Jewels Conference. Let's watch this. Our worth was already given together with our beating hearts. And that's why your heart is the most valuable thing on earth. And this is for you to empower you.
your love is the strongest force in the universe.
Reaction is a reaction, and no.
Let God protect you from the wrong one.
Can't let it divide us. Something inside.
We are not bodies to be used. We are hearts, we are souls, we are spirits to be seen, to be known, and to be loved.
We will bring.
Just here for you, and we also want you to be here for us.
I believe in the beauty of love. I believe that
we are here for you, and we can help bridge the gap and lead you to a better place, which we are now enjoying.
What can be called? You can't let it divide. Something inside us, a power that grows. Something beautiful in the flower.
Fall in love some more with Coco Martin.
Church is a canoe where the elderly help read the stars and the young row with their strength. It's such a beautiful picture. If we could just bridge the gap, we can really reach our destination.
You need three things: humility, selflessness, and trust. Blessed are the bridge builders. Blessed are the peacemakers. They will be called the mature children of God. And so the question is not whether you're a daughter of God. You are. My question is this: have you matured? And the way to know you've matured is if you are a bridge builder, a peacemaker. Are you?
All right. So with that, we want to invite all the women, whatever stage or phase of life, to next year's Jewels Conference. You can block off the date already. Do we have a photo? Oh, no, we don't yet. But it's on June 6, 2020. The theme will be All Things New. And so this is a great movement that's happening all throughout the different feasts to really raise up women that will honor God and build great families in Jesus' name. Amen. Can invite you all to stand. Apologize for a bit over time, but you're blessed. Yes? Amen. Lift up your love offering envelopes and let's pray together. Heavenly Father, we thank you for your goodness and grace that has continued to transpire in our lives. We embrace the now. We embrace the present for all that you're doing. And we know and believe that whatever the future holds, whatever this coming week holds, we're going to trust you. We're going to believe, Lord God, that you will be at work doing great and amazing things. So we thank you, God. All this we pray in Jesus' name. Amen. Come in front, drop your love offering envelopes, and let's sing in God's presence.
Come on, put your hands together.
I will perceive fear in the moments. For whatever comes, I know you're there for me. You've been so, so good to me.
Sing. My King.
My King. Forever I will sing of the wonders of your love. Love that gives me peace. your life. You gave it up for me. There's no fear that will be. You love away from me. I'm alive and now I'm free. Even when I can't see what I can see, there is so much more than what I can see. Don't you gave me all these hopes and dreams. I was just in you. I was just in you. Even when I can't see what I can see, there is so much more than what I can see. But you gave me all these hopes and dreams. I was just in you. I was just in you. My King.
Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be,